What's up, Jessica? What's up, Lulin? Thanks for joining. You're sharing that shit into the club. Damn, I thought this is me and my swearing. How's it going, guys? 14 peaks, what's up? Imran. He's a Leeds boy, Imran is.
Oh.
Yeah. Hey, Alex. The wild Alex appears. Morning, Kevin. Afternoon. Yasun, how's it going? Mr. Lu. How's it going, yo? Morning, Tyler. Ask good evening. What's going on? Can you guys hear us all right? What's up, Jonas? What's up, Amber? Thanks for joining. What's up, Casper? You have a go, mate.
All right,
I gave you the hard one. What's up, Giancarlo? Yeah, she can hear us all right. Hey, thanks, Chocos, for sharing the video.
Right, no worries. Audio's fine. Sounds really weird. I don't know.
What?
Today.
What do you mean?
Sounds really quiet. Hey, Emma.
Back to us, mate.
What?
Hey, Emma.
Hey, Emma. Thanks for joining, guys. Thanks for joining the first live Q&A in 2017.
What's up, Gene? What's up, Manny? What's up, Alex? I'm gonna roll that off.
Hey, Brianna.
Hi, hello, Brianna.
Yeah, let's go. Sup, Alex. Bastaki. What's going on? It's Maria.
How's everyone this year?
Yo, Mike. It's in the house. Andreas. Who's the new guy? Introduce yourself, yo.
Yo, I'm the new guy.
Sup, Andrew. Sup, Savage. Josh. Thanks for joining. Billy, go 7 for 7. I wonder how long you keep going. Sup, Jerome.
7 for 7. That's one way to put it.
Yo, Sav, we actually put that in the club, say that we were going to be live streaming the day beforehand.
Yes.
Sup, Olivia. Sup, Liam. He likes your hoodie. Jake does.
Nice.
Sup, Benson.
You have good taste.
Sup, Tiago. Jorge. Carl. Squanning.
That was quick.
Yo.
A bunch of them joining in.
Yo. 50 peeps, yo. Morning, Michelle.
Everyone had a good year? Good new year?
How you guys doing? Stefano. Honestly, Savage, you gotta be on there even more all day, mate. 25 hours a day. It was in the 25th hour. You obviously weren't paying attention. Thanks, Olivia. Appreciate the comments on the Dark Souls. What's up, Robert?
45 people. Ooh.
What is guts, guys? Giovanni.
Hey, Sav.
All right, let's get the show on the road. What is up, guys? Thanks very much for joining us. Kevin, joining in the last moment. As always, my co-host, introduce yourself.
Yo, this is Chocos here.
Boom! Cameo by our main man, Jeff.
Hi, everyone.
What's up, Al Davis? Let's give Jeff some love for joining on the stream today. Let's see some love for Jeff. Let's see the love, guys. Let's say, give Jeff a nice warm welcome.
I get a thumbs up.
What's up, Jeffrey?
Loving
yo.
Loving this.
Andrew's up for ordering some more botaners, ordering for more F4Fs. What's up, Matthew? Thanks for joining. Hey.
Yeah, a lot of stuff. Thanks, guys.
Love, yeah. Morning. Yes, yeah, calling you, Tiago.
Nice. Hi, Tate. Hi, Tiago.
Thank you.
What's up, Christian? What's going on? Hey, hi, Brianna Singer. Yeah, thanks for sharing Jeff the love. He's loving it. We're all loving it. Except for Chocos, who's writing stuff, busy. Ah, I see what you're doing, yeah. All right, sweet. Yeah. Right, guys. Marcella likes the hair. Giancarlo. All right, guys, thanks very much for joining. We're going to kick this off. It's another week in review. Whilst Chocks is busy doing something, he'll jump in a minute to say what's going on. He will explain why he's been so busy and being so unsociable right now. But in the meantime, I've got my main man here, Jeff, on the left of me, who is, hold on, let me bring up the Q&A, who's going to help me do the weekend review. So what happened on Monday? Nothing, but kiss. What are you doing? Chilling. Well, we're closed.
I'm actually working as well, replying emails, but yeah, wasn't chilling.
On the second?
Yeah, you know, I'm a hardworking guy.
That's true. So I'd like to hear. Let me pull up the Q&A. How do I search for that? Q&A. Let's bring up those comment questions. Then then what was up? The Tuesday we came back in to a lot of emails.
A lot of emails.
Jeff's hair looks a little bit like a heart upside down. You see? Everyone's saying cool hair, and I'm totally jealous. I wish I had some of that.
No comment.
How was our day? Well, we're doing the week in review, so you'll find out when we get back to Friday. Sup, Jose. Thanks for joining. So that was Monday. Tuesday, we're back at work. A lot of things to catch up on.
Definitely.
Man, it was just like sort of spending time in the club, of course. There was lots of those Christmas sneaks. Which one of those Christmas sneaks was your favourite, Jeff?
I think I would a lot probably be Berserk. I mean, I'm a big fan of Berserk. So that's probably my favourite one.
Yeah.
I can't wait to see it. I'm not seeing anything, guys. I'm not seeing anything at all.
Well, I mean, obviously you've seen the pictures, but you prefer...
I pretend I didn't see the pictures. keep it fresh and...
keep it fresh.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. And then what do we do on Wednesday?
Wednesday.
Do you remember anything particularly big on Wednesday? We got a Pac-Man statue in. We got a Item 2 Mega Man statue in for the raffles.
And the Lincoln's...
Link vs. Servo, the diorama. So we need to open those up.
Yeah.
Check those out, see the quality
definitely.
Is okay or not.
Mm-hmm.
Brianna says she needs an answer to her email so I can stop freaking out. Well, Brenda is still in the office, so what's your issue, Brianna? Chocks, Walter says you've always got the best sweaters and hoodies.
Good taste. How about you, Walter?
What happens if 0 hour gets da-da-da-da-da? Does the other person get... Yeah, so that's correct. If somebody's 0 hour, we have to add the hologram... And we have to add the 0 hour card at the point it's in China. So if that person cancels their order, even after 0 houring it, the person who gets it converted off the wait list will be Christmas for him or for her. So absolutely, there's nothing we can do about it. Once it leaves the factory, there's nothing we can do about that. Andrew says he likes the Alphonse hint. I don't know what he's talking about. Who's an Alphonse?
What hint?
What's up, Austin? Yeah, I don't even know what he's saying.
What hint?
then that was a Wednesday. Thursday, oh well, yeah, obviously on Tuesday a big thing, we had Chris join the team.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we had
some right.
stuff. Yeah, he's getting slammed. There is a lot of stuff. Chris, if you're watching, what is up, mate? There is a lot of stuff for him.
Get back to Skype.
CC issues. Should we bank stop the overseas payment if they only be put fully on notice? I think my pre-order would be cancelled. Brianna, we're never going to cancel your pre-order just willy-nilly. Hey, Brenda.
Yeah?
There's a Brianna Sanderson who's basically saying, oh, what's up, Jono? Basically, she's only got a certain amount of time that the overseas bank, lets overseas payment, i.e. us, take her money, i.e. 48 hours. We're going to miss that, clearly, because the office is closed. If you haven't taken the money, it means that you're not going to be able to do it within 48 hours. So if you see Brianna Sanderson, don't cancel her order. Much appreciated. She says she's going to cancel your order anyways. Oh, sorry, I misunderstood. She says, it's all good, Brianna. Don't you worry. She's not going to cancel your order. What's up, Dan? Thanks for joining. Veronica, thanks for joining. Chris is under the world of pain. He's like, oh, yeah, I can handle it. Right, let's see. There's a lot of stuff to get going on, so he's got a lot to learn. He's been thrown in the deep end. If I order two of the same statues on the same order, will I both get at the same time? Will the numbers follow each other? That's a pretty interesting question. I think technically, I guess the answer would be yes.
It would be yes if they're organizing the same ship.
Yeah, I don't see why not. That's an interesting question. Hey,
Brenda,
have you ever had a situation when someone's ordered more than one product at once? So let's say they order two of whatever item it is, that they get the same, like, say it's a new line, do they get, like, number three and number four, as an example?
Because they're a different item.
No, the same item, but they order two of them,
mm-hmm.
and they're both exclusive, as an example. Will they get three and four, or, you know, consecutive numbers? They should do, right?
It should be.
Should be. Do you want to test that out? Yeah, it should be. Kevin says he got two Shenmue's and they were sequential. So, yay! Good job, operations. Let's give Brenda the love because she managed to get that organized.
Actually, that one is organized by Sunny.
Gotta give Sunny the love when he's actually in town and he's actually in the office. Jessica says you might as well join the stream, Brenda. You want to join?
Good idea.
She says no. Next time. It's better to say hi and be on social. Tiago, I'm going to ignore your comment because, you know, there's only so much that I can ask for Brandon to do. Andrew, you're very welcome for your 3 points. What is up? So, that also Chris joined, etc., etc. That was pretty much it. I'm pretty sure. I'm not sure. I mean, yeah, we got 100,000 holograms. But, you know, it was 100,000 holograms amongst mates, yeah?
Yeah.
So, you got 100,000 holograms came into the office. That was good to see. Then, that was this morning.
This morning, yes.
Yeah, of course, throughout the whole week, of course, there was also the secret projects that were arriving and that we're looking at now and all the stuff that we're working on.
Yep.
Of course, we're not going to mention any of that.
Yet.
No bloopers tonight.
No bloopers today. What happened to Zero? Benson, that is a bit of trouble at the moment because the factories are saying it's super hard to make and it's become super expensive. And we've changed the face. So that's a little bit like, So it hasn't been forgotten about, but it's quite technically quite tough. Quite tough because it's so full of lights, it's quite hard. Lay your cars with them. Speaking of which, it's January, and that basically means I've got another month window to apply one more time for my F4F license plate. I've been trying.
Chuckles. Are we gonna go do that as well? Mm-hmm. Are we
gonna apply for the license plate?
Yeah.
As well?
Yeah. What? $1 higher?
If I contact Sears and pay for the whole statue right away, will I get the statue faster than those who wait to the date? Absolutely not. The answer is no, you will not, Jonas. that would be very cheeky, and that's not where we're not worried about. You do that. Okay. No, do that. Because look at what Chocolate just wrote to me. No, just stay there. Okay. Hold on 1 sec. Okay.
Did you get the questions up on your screen?
No, I didn't actually. Did you find it?
Yeah, I've got it on my screen.
Alright, cool.
Yeah.
Thanks.
I have no idea. What's going on?
Matthew Lopez knows what's up. What's up, Mr. Talon? How's it going?
Hey, Talon.
I keep doing these bloody poopers. What is wrong with me?
What are we hiding?
He's already seen it. He knows what's up.
No. It seems I wasn't fast enough.
So yeah, boom, that was the week in review. Chocks, hit us with the questions.
Questions, all right. That was quick. Wow, quite a lot of questions this week.
Yo. Shall I just bring it up over here? Just bring them up quicker,
yeah?
Alright, okay. Cool. So what's it under? It's Q&A? How did you come up with that?
Just search your name.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Or 24 hours with Q&A.
24 hours is what you need to write?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, 24 hours. Let's see what's up. Oh, of course, we did a little sneak peek of Guts and everyone got all, like, divided. But don't worry, guys, it's just a work in progress.
That's right, guys. I mean, keep on coming with the feedback. So, you know, we've seen all the changes. We've seen all the requests.
We're already working on it, guys. We don't rest.
It's going to be hard because, like, there's been so many different variations of Guts over the years, from the manga to the original animes and the OVAs and the recent new anime as well. So, you know, we'll try and make things balance. Obviously, everyone has their own different definition of, like, different expressions, action pose, static poses, whether he should be grinning, smiling, you know, the crazy berserk mode, or just being a neutral, you know, being, you know, angry without any motionless. So we've definitely heard you guys. We've actually read through all the comments and
We got you guys back. You worry, guys.
We always listen, guys. Don't worry. That's the whole process always repeats itself every time we do a statue.
Absolutely. All right, here we go. Alex Hughes, what is your goal for the year? Jeff.
Not to piss my boss off.
Chocks.
Make more statues, make more money, make the world go round.
30,000 members into the club by the end of the year. Let's go, guys.
That's right.
16,000 already, 1 week into it. That's a good start.
Yeah, 20k by half of the year, like by mid-year. And then, you know, keep on going. It's doable.
Doable.
It's doable.
20k by middle of the year.
Yeah.
If we don't hit that, but we need to be hitting it.
Yeah, but the latter half of the year is quite good as well. Just letting you guys know.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, the second half of the year is very good.
Yeah. Yuri, we are the whole website. I mean, that's actually what we've been doing this
mainly
week.
This week, yeah.
It's just been sort sorting out.
Apart from the Guts and apart from the Temptation Thursdays, you crazy fans, you know, no dramas, please.
Oh, yeah, you need to review that as well.
Yeah, but we'll talk about that. But obviously, this week has mainly been about the website. You know, we've been receiving a ton of private messages and customer service emails as well about, you know, how messy it is on the website, where you can't see payment details, your breakdowns, you can't edit your credit card information, or how come your wait list seems like it's pending, you know, seems like it's converted.
Yeah, that's Benson was saying that, so processing versus pending and all that sort of stuff.
And we've actually created a specific thread on the in the club as well, so if you guys find any issues, please post that into the specific thread, you know, F4F website. If you've got any issues or any suggestions, please put that in the club.
Yeah. For sure. Benson asked any updates on the calendar. The answer is no.
We're working
we're aware of that.
I mean,
it's on our to-do list.
Christoph has been chasing me on the first day back at work. Yeah, and chasing again today. But yeah, we've got this. Mm. We've got this.
Marcella says that likes the making of videos. Thanks for actually watching them. Hopefully, you watched all of them.
Awesome.
As in, like. Yes. The length of them.
They're not bad. They're all under an hour, so it's not bad. It's better than, like, they're all under an hour.
Yeah, it's good.
I mean, that's what you want. We've got these Q&As within there. We've got the shout-outs. We've got all the measurements.
Yep.
Starting from this first documentary, we're going to start weighing our statues as well.
Thanks to
Jeremy.
Jeremy,
you know, our admin guy with the
scales.
That's
what we've got this week. You're going to mention that as well. Got that in.
And always just giving a shout out to Jono as well. Thanks for the descriptions. A lot of these descriptions that you see on the website, you know, we always ask our admin guys, you know, everyone chips in, which is quite good.
It really is. Yeah. As I said, this is just as much of a... you know, as a community thing.
It's not just the collectors club, is everything.
Absolutely
cool.
Sweet. All right. Bada bing. We got it here. Nicholas asks, when's Alucard coming? I would say it's being printed at the moment, so we had the physical before, we're now changing the head, adding some weapons, and so that will be, I hope to see some more development on that before Chinese New Year, get the print out at least, and then after Chinese New Year, we'll be able to sort of paint that up, finish that up, get that approved, and then earlier on. Yeah. Okay. The other thing is, well, let's see. Peter Decker asks, when are we going to view our authentications on the website? The answer is you can already. You just go to My Account and then click on My Account again, and then you find your authentication.
Yeah, the options should be on the left-hand side. Oh, one important thing.
What's up?
Guys, double payments for sick.
Oh, yeah, right. That was a big boo-boo, wasn't it?
Yeah, apologies for that, definitely.
Yeah, big boo-boo on that. There was double payments on SIF. What happened was, and this is going to be a bit technical here. It goes from the Magento website and it goes into something called SagePay. And then it goes to your bank. What basically happens is Magento tells SagePay that to take your money, but it made a mistake and it said two of them. So SagePay went to take two from your accounts. But the way SagePay works is it collects all the money over the day, and then at the end of the day, it submits them all. So we managed to catch SagePay before the hour arrived, i.e. wait, it's actually going to take the money from you guys, to void one of the payments, leaving only one payment to be taken, which is correct. And therefore, yes, some banks are different. It would have basically meant that some of the payments would seem that they were both being pending in on your account. One of them only should have gone through, and one of them should be, if it's still pending, will hopefully disappear because we voided it. Now, to be clear, Magento thinks it's taken that second payment. There's no way to cancel this payment in Magento without canceling your entire order, and I'm sure you guys don't want that. So, in order to stop that from happening, we basically don't tell Magento that we've stopped the second payment. It thinks it's taken it. We let it to continue to think it's taken it. So if you look under your invoices, it thinks you paid it, but in reality, you haven't paid that second payment. So what happens in a month's time when you should have taken that, we should be taking that money, we go back to SagePay and we ignore Magento. We simply say, take this amount of money, and then boom, then they match up. So for a month difference between the two, Magento is gonna say that you've paid two, but the reality is you've only paid one. I'm not sure if it was like, you know, X amount already into the SagePay, already into the FlexiPay line. I'm not sure.
Do let us know, guys. I mean, what does your bank? I mean, how long does a bank take to re-update your statements and accounts? I mean, that's good information for us
sure.
In the future as well.
Yo, Digimon, let's do that for TT. Hey, Michael, what are you? What can you do if you're hiring? Are we hiring? Okay, Steve says he hasn't got his money back in the account, so just do keep an eye on that, please, mate. Okay, so Ricky Underdog Pal, will we ever get a glimpse into the FRF vault, some old concepts and renders, or is it a problem due to licensing still waiting on that history of F4F art book? You know what, having read that...
I'm bouncing, any question for me?
You know that SIF payment? That SIF payment, was it the first SIF payment, or was it like the second one? Of the 7 month,
the second.
It was the second one, so we took second and third, basically. Yeah. All right, guys. You heard it from Brenda.
Any question? Last chance.
Any questions for Brenda? Quick.
That's right, quick. Guys. You can send your emails in, but they won't be looked at until next Monday.
Yeah.
The office always closed at the weekends for the CS guys. So.
I work at home.
Yeah.
Absolutely. It seems that you're getting some love. There doesn't seem to be any questions, so I think you have managed to make it out alive.
Yes.
All right, have a lovely weekend.
Bye.
See
guys.
You. Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Tiago says you have a lovely laugh. Brenda.
She's gone. She didn't hear that.
So, yeah, that's right. This week was all a bit about sort of. Sorting out the websites and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Cool.
Unexpected.
So we're talking about the FRF Vault. I've decided that because they're quite unique and because it has licensing issues, that the only way I'm going to crack open that FRF Vault is if you're sitting next to me and I'll show you there. So all that Link versus Volvagia, all that, you know, Master Link putting out the swords, worked on Tingle, worked on Metroid stuff, crashed Metroid Prime gunships, you know, all this sort of goodness, all these licenses we went for, we made like Pokemon like designs and we did this and we did that. Boom, you want to see it? Come on over. Sit where Chocks is sitting, sit where Jeff is sitting, and I'll show that to you.
How long would that take to show the entire vault in one sitting?
I don't know.
There's quite a lot
there's
of stuff.
There's quite a lot there.
Right. I've been banging on this
like
for 13 years. So
13 years worth of stuff, right?
Yeah. There's so much stuff in there. That you guys would be like,
Yeah. I don't know if I've ever seen 5% of the stuff.
Nah, not even. It's a lot of stuff. you got to book a flight, but of course you got to get past the bouncers at the door. I got to explain that part. This table is the furthest away from the entrance, so you got to get past all the bouncers before you can actually get to the table to actually see the vault. So Wesley, thanks for joining you. You got to get through all the bouncers. That's
all
right.
All the bouncers.
That's absolutely right. So we are right. Moving on.
A few more questions.
Yeah, there's quite a few. Matthew the Law Sharp, have you ever attempted to expand your Metroid license to cover other Metroid statues? Well, aren't we already doing... Well, we've done Prime 1 and 2. I guess he's asking anything other than Prime. May or may not be working on something else. then... Jeff, you know exactly what we've been working on. do you guys ever make prototypes before getting licenses to improve the license? Impress a lot. Yes, Natalie, we do. Absolutely. Sometimes they work, sometimes they don't. Mm. Sometimes they end up in the F4F vault. And let's see. Alexander asks, will you ever consider making a minor character like Queen Rutella from Twilight Princess? She's the most lovely statue. Because Darunia is really main, isn't he? All right, moving on. James Bucky Barnes. He talks about Link with the Master Sword, pulling it out. Done. Al Davis, have you ever considered revisiting versions of the statues already been made? So it does kind of like break my heart to think of all the Fierce Deity Links and the Skull Kids and all that sort of stuff. The old school stuff. Mm-hmm. Now, you see some of the competition. Don't want to say names. Basically everybody, you have one major character and they keep making him mm-hmm. or her, or you know, that character many, many times, different scales, different this, different that. Now, to be honest with you, I would absolutely love to get another crack at things like Fierce Deity Link and those sort of things, but there is still so many things that we haven't done yet that it would almost be a waste to do that, even though I know we could mash it up now and do so much better. It would be a waste of resources to do that, despite knowing that the sales would be, you know, humongous or whatever.
But if you didn't have that, like, resource issue, would you be doing the same thing? Because I remember you saying you wouldn't mind doing the same thing, but it would have to be a different pose.
Oh, that's for sure. That's non-negotiable. So I would never re-release something.
Yeah.
Chris wants to know anything about, was it a Banjo Kazooie?
What about it?
He wants to know, is there any possibility of it?
Of Banjo Kazooie?
Yeah, you've got to hit up Bear.
Alright then. I'll send an email to Bear.
Yogi Bear.
The Bear Studios, right? Yeah, I know them well.
Hey Matthew, I love money, but I also love having a better reputation. Sometimes things are priceless. Moving on. Christoph, any news about the pre-order calendar? Boom, let's get working on that.
Again, Christoph?
Various suit update, that is sculpting the changes, adding this, tweaking that. It's not going to, as you know, we're still aiming for Q3 for release on that. Is there any way to find out what number you're on the wait list? So the wait list is like this. This is the wait list. Then, once it goes, we don't know about the wait list until we shift our stuff into the different warehouses. Then what happens is, because we've got four different warehouses, the wait list actually fragment. So yes, you were over here, and let's say you were the last person in the wait list, right? Mm-hmm. But you're based in Asia, as an example, right?
Yeah, sure.
Right? When we fragment them into the different warehouses, basically it means that, you know, there's a wait list for the American region, for the Canadian region, for the European region, and Asian region. So it's very possible in this scenario where you, having joined the waitlist right at the end,
right,
actually gets it over someone who was much earlier.
Based on my region.
Because there was only one person ahead of you on the waitlist mm-hmm. in Asia. Or maybe you're the only person in Asia that was on the waitlist. And as soon as there's one cancellation in the Asia region, boom, you're there. Mm. So you could jump all the other people simply, so it's really hard to say where are you in the wait list. You really need to wait until it's in the warehouses. And after it's in the warehouse, that's when you can really sort of tell about that. That's when you can really see us, and they can tell you with clarity. Wesley asked, any chance for Assassin's Creed? There's always a chance for anything. It's magic. So, Jerome, you're on back moving to Asia. Last Airbender, any possibility with Aang? Yeah, that was a really interesting TT that was. Chocks, hit us on the TT, what happened?
Oh, this week. Oh, let me just search that up.
All right, cool. Yeah, Jeremy asks, how do you like the increasing trend of video game statues as packaged parts of special editions? You know, that's quite an interesting thing. I'm actually quite all up for it, especially when we're the ones who make them. But, you know, we obviously made the mini Ganondorf, we made the mini Skull Kid. We actually made the Alcatraz figure for EA's Crisis 2. There was, you know, there's been quite a few of them. The original Assassin's Creed, we made that for the European version. I actually quite don't mind it. I mean, I'd like to hear your opinions on it as well, because it actually leads, if people start buying, because they're gamers, and they buy the collector's edition, they all of a sudden get a statue. Mm-hmm. And they go, oh, okay, it's a statue. And then they get another, you know, exclusive edition, collector's edition, and they get another statue. And then all of a sudden they have two. And that's the start of a collection. And then when they see those, and then they hopefully stumble upon us, and then they can see, okay, actually there's differences. It's almost like you know, getting gamers to become collectors, because it's quite, I find it quite often that most gamers just like to game. What do you think, Chocks? What's your idea on the CEs?
Yeah, I mean, like, before, back in the day, people were saying a collector's edition actually worth it, and some people say that, oh, a lot of these collector's editions came with like skins and multiplayer, you know, soundtracks and stuff like that. But I think over time people realised that nobody actually wanted those. They actually wanted some like physical things.
So they can see.
So maybe, yeah, like I say, like a proper statue or proper something, a bag or something like that. At least something like, because some of these stuff you do want to have it on display. Some items you just put it back in the box.
Yep.
Like pins and maps. What are you going to do with that? Right? So collector's editions have changed over time, and especially these few years where they're packing collector's edition with just a tin case without the actual CD.
Yeah, so because you don't know exactly what range it's for. Like, you could get it for, you know, different
without, you know, without the actual game.
Yeah, because it means that you can add your own game later.
Yeah,
to it.
Or
yeah.
if you buy a digital version, you can actually buy the actual separate thing.
Yeah,
yeah. It's kind of like weird now though, these days, collector's edition.
Yeah. Jeff, what do you think?
Yeah, I mean, like you said, because nowadays people like to see a lot more things. But it's, you know, if I'm buying a game, I would have to see something with the game.
Yeah, exactly.
You know? I mean, it's fine having DLCs and, you know, like CDs and so on, but for me personally, I would like to have something more with the game.
Absolutely.
Or even a T-shirt or something. You know?
Yeah. So you know, in terms of for us, I think it's as I said, it's actually the start of people to actually start accidentally. Mm. Accidentally becoming collectors, if you know what I mean. Sup, Ashley, thanks for joining. Okay, moving on. Let's see. Okay, we're gonna. James asked, any plans to grab the Mass Effect license? The answer is no. We have a very good relationship with Gaming Heads. And moving on, we have. Have you guys had any meetings with Monolith Soft, Kevin? Any questions that I, you know, any questions like that, I don't, like, that I don't.
Is there still quite around? Monolith.
Then, Tiago says, you said you have new licenses to announce. When can we expect a new license announcement? And when do you expect the pre-order to be opened? Okay, so
when we normally announce a new license, we don't announce a pre-order at the same time.
But I think it's a separate thing.
Two questions.
So I think it's possible that by the end of this month, we may have an announcement of the first one. We have five to get through, so...
Mm-hmm.
And there's always more coming on, so...
Come on, 20K? There'll be something announced.
Oh, well, 20K is another one.
Yeah.
Another big one.
That's another big one. Huge one! It ain't small, guys, honestly. It's not small. And Matthew Lopez says, I've already hinted a few acquisitions. I don't even know what you're talking about. So in terms of a new pre-order going live, we're still juggling a few things. He's asking also, you know, this was Tiago asking if there was any about the next pre-order, and still juggling a few things.
Sure.
Alessio asks, how's your little boy? Harvey's doing very well. He actually said to me, oh, what are you doing on the live stream? Can I do it as well?
Already?
Yeah. Spencer. Harvey. Spencer. I said Harvey.
Oh, okay. Yeah, exactly.
And even Bella said, can you next time ask Chuckles not to strangle me? Is what.
Poor Bella. She
loved it.
You know Alex is serious when he goes for Senna, says. Do you all get a booth at any major comic cons? If you guys promise to help us set up that booth, we'll be there. SDCC, what is up?
And the rest.
Because, man, setting that shit up on our own is like...
it'd be nice to have actual fans setting up as well. Yeah, we can actually meet and greet.
Definitely.
Yeah. Xavier and Mrs. Doggo. Any European conventions? We've got to start somewhere. Yeah. We've got to start somewhere. Natalie says she'll help. Much appreciated.
Awesome. Thanks.
Yo, thanks. Brian Kissy knows. What are the thoughts of Space Channel 5 now that the poll is over?
Oh, interesting. I enjoyed that game. I played it quite a lot on the Dreamcast.
Ooh, la 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 la.
But you know these Temptation Thursdays. You gotta love them.
I was gotta say I was pretty disappointed with that.
Sure. Quite a lot, really.
Yeah. Mm. Matthew M says, any chance for Luigi or Modern Tales statues? Always a chance.
Give us the Sega love.
Give us the Sega love, guys. The Sega love. How many Tekken? Richard Yafai. How many Tekken statues will be coming up this year?
Oh, haven't really counted.
There's a fair few. I got that one, followed by that one.
Hey, Brenda.
And then there's that one. What's up, Brenda? Thanks for joining, guys. Can you give Brenda the love? She's just joined. Show Brenda the love. Give her some. Ba-boom, ba-boom, ba-boom. Give Brenda some love. And if you've got any questions, feel free to ask her directly in the. Hey, Brenda's got the love. Brenda's got the love. Loving it. Brenda's, what's up? All right, cool. So, will Ami bust edition close 2 weeks after 2 weeks? Life-size busts are usually slower sellers. The answer is absolutely. It is a new thing for us.
Definitely.
But I don't see why we would do any different. We do the first one and we see. And if we like sell two, then maybe the answer is we have to leave it slightly longer. Yeah. But I, at least at the beginning, and we need to sort of have that confirmed before we actually go live, is to actually do that. Mm. It's to actually, you know,
stick with the rules, with a
predefined sort of criteria, which will be i.e. the 2 weeks. So the answer is it will be 2 weeks. Colton Shane Myers says, when can I expect Bayonet? You are missing the A there. When can I expect a Bayonet? What's a Bayonet, guys? It's been almost 1 year since you began the CC from Jeremy. What has surprised you the most?
Is it 1 year?
Eighth.
The eighth, right, yeah, because I saw the admins were like, you know, like, discussing with this.
Eighth.
Eighth.
What's up, Anthony? What's up, fam?
What should we do on the eighth?
What should we do?
Eighth is what, Sunday?
Announcement?
Announcement? We announce it's being closed. Would you guys be upset if we closed it?
Close what?
The club.
One of those PewDiePie things, yeah?
Alright, he's deleting his channel.
Yeah, we'll delete our club on the 8th.
I love it. Everybody, you know, sad faces if he's going to the club,
right?
Yeah.
It's 1 year already. Wow.
It's funny because it's like everybody uses any excuse to have a sneak. So look, Matthew Lopez, yeah. 1 year anniversary sneak. And then, like, I see Christoph, he's like, oh, 16K, sneak? Yeah. Like, hey, it's a, you know, it's a Friday at 11:21 over here. Mm. Sneak? yeah, basically, the answer is, you know, obviously, you know, 1 year, it will be nice. It's going to be, it's a lovely, lovely thing. I mean, it's gone so quickly. And it's grown so well. And so what has surprised me is just how it's developed into, you know, I set it up. I was in it and I was like, well, whatever, just set this up, whatever. I don't even know what this does. Mm. Set it up. Hey, guys, what's even a group? And then people came. And that first day, I really remember, like, so many people kept coming in. I was just sitting there going, yeah, accept people coming in. I was like, man. And they started posting their collections. And I was like, damn. Mm. And then I had to get the addies in, get some guys.
Who was your first admin?
I had a bunch of people. There was Celine. Well, obviously Jono and Alex were there right at the beginning. They were like the first two people I invited in. Then
you asked in the club. I remember you asked in the club.
Yeah, who wants to be? Yeah, I asked who wants to be an addy, and a bunch of people, sort of said some stuff. Mm-hmm. And yeah, absolutely.
Great.
Yeah. No, it's really really cool. Really really cool. Hey, Ricky Underdog Power, I already answered your question, mate. You snooze, you lose. If he would talk about the F4F Vault. Mm. Poor guy.
You can always watch back.
You can always watch back.
Yeah.
Okay, moving on, we have... Reme asks, when can we approximately expect a pre-orders for Majora's Mask? Will it come sort of some sort of stand? Da-da-da-da-da-da. The answer is... We need to figure that out. No. We're still throwing some things up in the air.
Yeah, don't say anything.
Yeah, we need to try to figure that out. Okay.
It's going to come out in Q1.
It's definitely Q1 is what we said. And we need to work on that pre-order calendar so people can then know.
Exactly,
yeah?
Yes.
Exactly.
And the rest, and the infographics.
Yeah, exactly right. Andreas asks, getting my pre-orders automatically the 5% standard website discount. When I reach... bronze, will my pre-orders automatically get the 10%? Your pre-orders will get 10. You only get your stuff at the point that you've completed. And if you've completed it as you're a different member, then you should, you know, technically be able to get them at that level. Now, whether or not the website can do that is another matter, but that should be what should happen. We need to, you know, the whole website is just being a bit of a nightmare. Mm-hmm. Shout out to Andreas, our Andreas, who's, you know, working tirelessly in the background. And shout out to Lorenzo if you're watching as well. If you are, stop watching, get back to working on the website. but for sure, you know, it's just been, let's just put out the fires first. And then once
we know it's going to be tough once we went live. That's why we were straight up front and say, hey guys, this new website is going to be shit. It's more of a sidestep or even a step back. But at least we got it out
Yo.
In 2016, Yo. Right?
Yeah.
So we
I did, managed to make all my highlights of the year.
We did achieve that target at least. But it's going to be a tough road ahead, but it's going to be taken. You know, we've got to do it.
Mm.
You know, all the fancy tricks and all the features and all the giveaways and all the... You know, reward points and all the lovely stuff that we couldn't do on the old website.
Yeah.
So, definitely.
Chocks.
Yeah.
Contest.
Yes, guys.
Maybe you want to do it afterwards.
Yeah, I'll do it afterwards, but I'll explain it right now. Yeah, I mean, if you guys stuck with us over the Christmas period, we did a photo contest where you actually send in your entry of your current statues or pull down the pictures on the website and just add a little Christmas theme to it. Thank you for all the entrants. We've got quite a lot through the main page. Sorry for those guys that got disqualified, you know, because you posted that into the club. We did say you can't post that into the club. For those that still want to enter, sorry, it's already been finished. We've already nailed down the 10 applicants or entrants right now. And after the stream, we're going to post those 10 images up. And it's going to be a voting poll. So it's going to be like A to J. These 10 entrants are going to be posted as comments, one after another, in the actual poll. And just a quick summary, the first winner is going to get 3,000 points, the second winner is going to get 1,000, the third winner is going to get 500, and the remaining seven are going to get 100 each. And then I'm going to choose the winners, or we are going to choose the winners, during next Friday's stream. How's that sound? We'll give you 1 week.
Yeah, well, we're not choosing it. They're choosing.
No. We'll announce the winner, sorry.
Then. Well, but they'll know who the winners are.
No, we can do it live, right? We might as well say, hey, guys, congratulations to...
Oh, yeah, sure.
We'll do the congratulations.
Yeah, we'll do the congratulations.
Yeah, on the
Q&A. It runs for 1 week, yeah. Yeah, exactly.
It runs for 1 week because also the votes is going to go on forever.
Yeah.
So we'll announce the winner during next Friday's Q&A with Chocks and A. And we'll go through the whole list. And right now, I've taken out the names. I've just labeled them A to J. So if you guys got entered into the poll, keep it hush hush, please.
Yeah, you should say that as well. Maybe in the PMs as well or whatever. Just to say you guys shouldn't really be saying. We don't want it to be a popularity thing, right? Just be focusing on the actual
thing. Try and keep it hush hush and just make everything nice and fair.
Yeah, basically that's what we're trying to do.
So I'll create that post after the stream so you guys can start voting away. And then guys, these daily Christmas specials that's been going on. How many reviews? Six or seven?
Six.
Yes, six reviews.
Seven reviews, but six actually up for the reward points.
Yeah, these go on for the entire month of whatever day was posted. So if it's posted on the December 25th, it will end on the January 25th. So if you haven't actually entered to those competitions or contests, feel free to go back onto the main page, enter your email address, and then we'll decide a winner on a couple of days after the actual contest has ended. Yeah. That's it. Any more? Have I left anything else?
Well, I think so.
Yeah. Have you guys been logging in every day?
You've been getting your points?
I think I've got about 50 odd points now just by logging every day. I don't know why I bother logging in because it don't mean anything to me, but well, it'd be cool, innit? How many points?
What's up, Kevin? Well, you have got a nice F4F discount already as an employee. You even need those points.
Yeah.
You want to be gifting them out to people.
I might give my points away.
Unfortunately, you cannot transfer your... So
1 year later, I'm going to give all my points away. And we've got to give...
What's up, Devin?
0 points. Why? Not signing in? Cool, 60
points.
Yay,
60 points for Alex. Nice one.
Nice
hey.
One, Talon.
Yeah, that's what I like to hear. Kick me down your... Sort him out.
All right, Sav.
For sure. So, guys, we are coming to the end of the...
How long has it been going on for?
It's already been going on for an hour, yo.
For an hour? Wow,
yo.
That's quick.
No. But, you know, of course, one thing that we would always do is just always... forget to take this out like this.
Take what out?
Take that out.
Oh, okay.
take out my speakerphones and stuff like that.
Is this something I should do?
Huh?
Is this something I should do?
No.
Oh man, not again.
Let's go, Jeff. Come on, let's show them. Your turn, Jeff. Let's go. Oh, yeah.
What's this we're here? What could it be? Come on, show us the hearts.
Bring that up.
You guys been there during Christmas. You know what's up.
Oh, what we got going over here? Yo. Yeah. So what have you got there, Jeff?
This is going to be more than just a Q&A. Hold on.
A pair of chopsticks, yo.
Guys, please share this video out. Share it to all the fans.
Share it out, guys.
All the fan pages, all the clubs that you know. Keep doing what you've been doing over the Christmas time. Keep them shared. Share it to Nintendo. Share it to Sega. Share it to From Software, Bandai Namco. Share it to everyone. Your mother, your father, your sister. Every single person that you know of, okay? Because, you know.
If you can share that out, guys, we're just going to be giving you a little bit of DMX that you come in. Let's wait for people to just give some love and share that in, because we got some important things that you guys gotta understand, and basically it'll be you guys are always the ambassador for us. You guys who watch the streams, you always give the information out to everyone, and that's really much appreciated. Yes. So thanks very much, guys. So the more people that's in the club, in the stream, can also help do that as well. Mm-hmm. Give some more information. Hey guys, there's 8 people who've shared the stream. Much appreciated,
thank
guys.
Thank you very much,
thanks
guys.
Thanks so much, guys. Stefan says, where is Silver on Sonic? Coming up very soon.
2017. Still within the anniversary year.
Yo, what's up? But, you know, on a serious end, that's looking sweet, though.
Yes.
Tania, much appreciated for sharing. So, let us do the thing and share. Much appreciated, Jessica. So, absolutely, Jeff, what have you got there, going on there? You shaved your head specifically for this, so you could put it on either side.
You combed your hair first. Oh, the devil's in town.
Whoa, what is that?
That Pikachu
is. I like it. Hey guys, what do you think of
Thanks for joining, Enrique.
Of Jeff's new hairstyle going on?
Screen cap that, please.
Yeah, just the missing a bit of hair here.
What the fuck was that? The quote? Oh, yeah.
Now you're looking for it.
There you go.
You found it?
You've suffered a terrible fate, haven't you?
I have. I've been put on live stream.
What is up, guys? We're happy to tell you that this is actually not only a Q&A day, but it is actually a it's a preview Friday. And we're very happy to now do these live stream preview Fridays. Brian, I already answered your question. You should have been watching
Do you guys remember what a preview Friday is? It's been a while, hasn't it? It's been like almost a month and a half or 2 months now. So yes, preview Friday live, something to show you guys.
Absolutely, guys. So not only are we changing it up by having today as a preview Friday on a live stream, but give us some love. Give Jeff some love if you want to see him show you the Majora's Mask right now. Do not need to wait until pre-order Tuesday, but right here, right now, do you want to see it? Show Jeff some love if you want to see it.
That's right, guys. Every time we had a preview Friday, we always post it in the club, on the main page, and sharing the club. And that's just an image.
Just a single, really small teaser
image. You had to wait until Tuesday, where we did a live stream to see it all. But right now, you know, send all that love from this side of the screen all the way to Jeff.
Let's go.
Let's go to my heart.
That's it. Keep pushing it to the left, onto the right, whichever you're
looking. Keep it coming, guys. Are you there yet? Have you got enough love yet?
Come on, power of the love.
He says it's not enough. He needs more love.
That's right.
He needs more love, otherwise.
We'll show this on screen live to you tonight on a Friday.
Yep. We've taken off for our Friday nights. He could have been chasing the ladies, but no. He said he wants to feel the love to show everybody.
Make sure you screen cap this, guys, for the people that can't actually join the screen. Obviously, we've got 16,000 members in the club, and only 81 of us are in here right now. So make sure you have your, whatever key, print screen key, or whatever key it is.
Yeah.
Post that into whatever you can find.
And for this, I am going to move over here. Chocks, move over slightly.
Right,
a bit.
Sure. Yeah,
just a little bit. If you come back a bit,
that's okay.
You can still stay in this thing. Jeff, you come in a little bit this way.
Okay. Are you nervous, Jeff?
Because what you're going to do is go and hold it like that. So when you get it, I'm being a bit dodgy here. But you go to hold it like that, and then that.
We should have prepared this.
Yeah,
this is like so.
So off screen, hold it. Do not drop it.
Hold
it
tight.
Right.
Do not drop it. Right. Don't throw that finger on this side. Yeah.
Okay.
All right. Exactly. Hey! I can't see you yet. We still can't see you. Yeah, there you go. So now you can see where you can be seen, right? So you've got to put your head there, and then you can bring it. But don't crack your head.
Keep coming with the love,
guys. Yeah, I can't see you. Let's see the love, guys.
Keep coming.
And we are. What is up? What is up? You've suffered a terrible fate, haven't you?
Hold on to the screen. Let them give it a pause. Let them screen cap it.
Very cool.
Take your snaps, guys. Share them out to the Zelda Club, Zelda fan pages.
Bada bing, bada boom, bada boom, bada boom, bada boom, bada boom. Bam! You're getting a lot of love.
Loving it.
A lot of love. And do not put it down there, because you know what that looks like.
You're going to keep holding it. You're going to keep holding it.
Smile on your face.
That's it, Jeff. Keep holding down until the end.
Yeah, that's what I like to see.
Well done.
Awesome. Good job. Then, there you go. How does that look?
It's a heart.
Hey,
Phil.
It's a big heart, isn't it? Show the hearts.
Hey, Phil. Thanks for joining. Hey, guys. Give more hearts for Phil. Phil just joined.
Our Phil.
Our Phil.
Yo, Phil. What's up in the house, mate?
Yeah. He's been working tirelessly lately. Just for you know, all the payment details, changes, credit card, PayPal. You know, when is this going to be released? Where's my shipment? Where's my statue? Blah blah blah. You know, etc. etc. You know, big up. You know, we know where you go during those toilet breaks. But you know, you always come back just for that one more email. You know, he's skipping lunch.
Yeah. Phil has been under the pump because lots of people be emailing him. So guys, give the love to Phil. Much appreciated. Right, yeah. Thanks so much for doing that, Phil. It's much appreciated. So yeah, absolutely. What is up in terms of, we now got the main event of the hour, and that is going to be Majora's Mask now gets its place in the sun. Of course, we can always rightfully just stick that. Is that a is an L?
L, is it L?
L1. Oh, right. Yeah. So that's a side one. Oh, is that a top?
No, the top.
Boom! Ooh. Just like that. That's some strong magnets, yo. Loud, yeah. Look at that. Oof. And then just... Damn! Did you hear that, guys? What is up, guys?
But as you collectors know, you guys are going to be way, way gentle than that, yeah?
Yeah, be gentle with that.
Be gently, right? You don't want to scratch it. You know, put it in from behind and then slot it forward. That's the best, easiest way.
It's, Jacob, if you're brave enough to go out with this expensive collectible on your face, mate, go for it. But it's not designed to be wearable. Absolutely not. It's going to work out, actually.
That's right, guys. I mean, obviously, what you see now is just a mask with the two spikes. There's always going to be spikes on both sides, so they're going to be magnetized as well, I believe, right?
That's right.
So they're very strong magnets as well. We've been like, throwing around with frisbee style, whatever. But they've been really strong. Just to let you guys know.
Give us some love, guys. If you like what you see with the Majora's Mask, you like the size of it, you like the way it's been constructed, you like what you see, let's see how it looks. Mohammed wants to know what it looks like on the back. You will see...
You want to show it on the back?
Yeah, you just gonna flip.
Flip.
Okay, it's just like that.
What could it be? Could it be a string to actually wear it around
your
head?
Yeah, what can anybody see what that might be over there? All right, guys.
Yeah.
Let's flip that back around. And why don't we, you know, whilst we're here, do you think it's, should we might as well just, you know, are you comfortable holding to us to actually just put in the,
as in
the other
bit?
The other horns? Is that right?
The other horns? Yeah, sure.
You go? No, say that, Chocks.
What's up?
Just get them. As in, they're over there. We just like boom, put them in there, so we can like see how it looks, so people can sort of get the full effect. It's going to go live on Tuesday, guys.
Yeah,
just
guys,
for your reference.
This is a preview Friday, so as you know...
R2. That's L. So R2.
This one?
R2 is here, yeah. Oops, this way around.
That's right, guys. So this is a preview Friday. So as you guys know, usually on a preview Friday, a pre-order Tuesday follows from a preview Friday.
What is this? L2?
Top.
That's it. L5. Yep.
And then 3 and 4.
L3. L4. Too heavy, mate? Are you okay?
I'm alright.
You're alright?
L4.
Well, that's because you've been working out, mate.
I try.
And then R5. Alright, if you give that a bit. Say, you guys, give some love for that. How does that look? Boom, boom, boom. Hope you guys like it. Hi, Sylvie. Thanks for joining. Perfect timing. And then give it a turn so people can actually see from the back. When you turn it from the back, before they could only see was just the purple. But now that you actually can see these, and you can actually see that these come over the edge. So if you look at the original, the actual model, that's how it does. It doesn't just stop there. It very slightly comes over. So that's how we've designed it. So take that off. If you look at the shape of these, you can see that there is a
an extra lip.
You can see the lip. There.
Yeah,
exactly. There's like a lip there. Like there, you can see it there. And then as an easy, where did it go? That one there. Oh, I don't even have to look for it. It's straight in. All right, guys. I hope you guys like what you see. Tuesday, it's coming. Tuesday is coming. All right, mate. You can put that word. Just say.
I'm going to take them all off again.
Take them all off now, because I'm.
Hey, Jessica.
Hey, Jessica.
Thanks for joining.
Yeah. All right, put that back over there.
Oh, be careful with something like Twitch, flicker, Twitch.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, because it's shaking, vibration.
Oh, okay.
It shook the cable or something.
Cool. Can we guys get some love for Jeff for holding that? He's had a serious workout, big muscles.
He's a strong boy.
That's why we, and that's the reason why we have Jeff here, because we had to get the strongest guy in the office to stay, because I couldn't hold it that long. Yeah, could keep that up for myself. It's the, you know, couldn't hold that up for myself for that long. So, absolutely, we are be very happy to to have shown that, and to say this Tuesday, the Majora's Mask will be going live for pre-orders. It is the first in a all-new series of Zelda prop collectibles. It is really, really important for anybody who is seriously considering a Zelda line, if you want to get a low number, to order early. You'll get that low number, and you will be entitled to that low number throughout the whole series. Don't want to make you guys upset, but I got number one.
And two's not up for grabs either.
So number three.
Are you going to number three this time? Are you going to number three?
I'm not going.
I should go to the last one.
I'm fair because I let these club members go before I decide.
Right, so we go for the last numbers then.
We always go.
So you guys are going to fight over the last numbers.
We have the last choice, yes.
So you're like, who's the last person to order it?
Yeah, we get
the order is closing in 3, 2, oh, you both missed it.
because somebody snacked in, like on the eBay, there's just like snipers.
Sup, Henzo, thanks for joining, mate. So, there's more to talk about than Majora's Mask. Not only have we completely changed things up in 2017 by showing you No Frills, it on preview Fridays, we're going to go more, and we're going to do one more thing for you guys. We're going to tell you the price right now, so you have the time to think about it, if it's something that you're interested in. And when I tell you the price, you have to remember you have not seen it all, so you have to consider that as well. It will have something extra with it, but just to say, I can give you an indication of what it's going to cost, so you can know and plan and decide should you want to buy it, should you want to be having a low number for the Zelda prop line. You can have the weekend to decide, and throughout the weekend, Chocks and I will be working overtime. We're going to be doing documentaries.
Yeah, we're doing that because we're slowly trickling a little bit more information for these up until the pre-order Tuesday.
Absolutely.
So today we're going to announce the price, but tomorrow will be boom, boom, boom.
Yeah, exactly.
We're going to be so busy every day.
Basically, you know, we can even release the
measurements.
The measurements, all that stuff. And also like the documentary.
Sure.
We can do that. It doesn't need to wait till the pre-order Tuesday. So the reason why we're giving this information now is because we are not going to be doing super long streams anymore. What the fuck? Oh, excuse me. We've already almost done a 2-hour stream just now. That's fine
for a Friday. But when it actually comes launch day, people just want to jump in and out straight away. But obviously, may I go? What am I saying? We're still gonna do a stream.
Yeah, exactly right.
Because we wanna be with you guys up until
so you can see when Chocks makes it live and all that sort of
stuff. Leading up until the actual pre-order launch, but we're gonna be there just like maybe half an hour before actual going launch. So it's not gonna be like a 2-hour or 5-hour jobby.
Yeah, absolutely. So it's all about having more information earlier, in order for you guys to have a more informed decision. We're testing this out. We're going to be much more open about things in the future. So before, what we used to do is tiny image and then reveal everything on a 4 or 5 hour stream. Yeah. on preview Tuesdays.
That's right.
Pre-order Tuesdays, pre-order and it became Tuesday. A little bit too hard. Mm-hmm. Now, this will be going live, in case you guys weren't sure, this Tuesday. And we'll be posting the information of when it will be a little bit later on. But it will be Tuesday. We'll be giving you times of when the stream starts. And we will be absolutely going live with it during the stream and give you a bit of indication of when it actually will
so
be.
So if you haven't already done so, please subscribe to the newsletter, because after this live stream, I'm going to start posting newsletters, and I'll be posting the actual posts, the Preview Friday posts on the main page.
That's right.
That will actually tell you the dates and the times as well. Make sure you mark that down, you save that date, make sure you check out the actual main photo on the actual main page in the club. And there's always, I'll let you carry on first before I actually jump in.
Yeah. That's right, okay. If you authenticate, you will get the same number. Oh, that's Al Davis. That's probably not talking to me. It's probably talking about Al Davis in the club.
Yeah.
Okay, so the price for the exclusive version. That's right, there's going to be two versions. Because someone was asking if there's going to be an exclusive version. Or
yeah,
what
sure.
Those,
yeah.
The price for the exclusive version will be announced tomorrow in another live stream. Oh, no. Sorry, I forgot. We're doing it now, right? We changed the subject.
No, we're doing it on Sunday. We're doing it on the 8th.
Hey, guys. Show us some love. If you're happy that you know it starts with an 800 something, show us some.
Hey Claudia,
show us some love.
We're like this, right? Claudia, there will be two versions, an exclusive and the regular version for this.
Yep.
Guys, there you go, Christopher.
You know, guys. Oh, it seems like no one's happy with 800. All right, fine, all right. Well, we're gonna change it. Hey, Andreas, change the back end so it doesn't say 800. Put it down to 700, please, mate. All right, guys, so it's going to be $700. What is up? Thanks very much for joining. Bada bing, bada boom. Laters, yo. What was that? You guys aren't happy? Oh, Jesus. All right, then. All right, mate. They're not happy with the 700. Bump it down to 600, please, mate. Yep, he's done it. He's 600 now, guys. Don't worry, guys. So Tuesday, boom, $600. See you later. Bye.
Not points, Sav.
800 points.
It's not points. How much?
Oh, come Jesus. On. God, there's more sad faces than crying faces. Are we still on 600 now? All right. 599.99. All right, guys. God, get on with it.
Yeah, at least it's not six.
Exactly, it's not a six.
It's not a six.
Here you go, guys. Honest price. $384.99. Coming your way for the exclusive. Show us some love. We do it to keep it very reasonable for what we offer, guys. Hope you guys like what you see. $384.99 for the exclusive edition. And to be clear, you have not seen it all. You know, it's going to come not with a one-to-one Skull Kid, because then the price would be there. You know, but
that's cheap. Very cheap. One-to-one Skull Kid.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, so that's what it is.
It's going to be male
or
female.
you know, that's what it's going to be. $384.99. Still haven't seen it all.
USD, guys.
US dollars. Right, exactly. I appreciate you guys. Look, we went hard. We got the price down to what we could get it down to. We ain't here for the short term snatch and grab. We ain't for the
really
dash and gong grab.
You guys saw it. I mean, this massive.
You saw.
I mean, the horns itself is like, you know, pretty much almost a can of a Red Bull.
Yeah, I mean, it's bigger than one to one. I mean, technically, you can see it. You know, it's pretty.
Yeah.
It pretty much covers your chest, Jeff. I know you've been measuring it.
Yeah, just about.
Thanks very much for the love, guys. I appreciate that. I think I'm glad that you guys appreciate the price as well. We're known for being. In fact, we got. Silver place for being bronze. No, silver place for being value.
Bronze
place.
Thanks,
by Rad
Titan.
Shout out to Rad Titan for giving
Alex
a
and
award.
Neo, thank you very much. You know, value for money. Hopefully, we could jump up a couple, two more slots this year. Maybe.
Yeah. but you know, we are known for being for value for money, and hopefully, you guys still agree that's where we're at, despite having a. You know, a much bigger team, we still keep it like that, okay, guys? So that's what we want to be doing.
So, back to bread and butter.
Absolutely. So, there's more. One more thing that we want to have a have a relatively quick discussion about, because it is getting late. And mad love to you, Jeff, certainly for staying so late.
you said it would be, it'd be quick.
is that the is a whole? I mean, this is the reason why we are sitting here this week, going through hell and pain with this new website. Mm-hmm. It is solely for this reason, 95% for this very reason. Yeah.
For this first pre-order of the year.
Is, you know, not for
it's,
this, no.
It's been building up.
Yeah, but is to say that we have, and it's still not perfect, but it's patched in a way that it's going to work, right? Is that this reward point system that you're beginning to understand, hey, what are my points expired? Oh, it should be legacy points or whatever it's supposed to be and all that sort of stuff. You begin to now understand these reward points. We did 6 days of giving out 105,000 points to... Is it 105,000 points or was it... No, it was... 461,000 points.
Yes.
For 115 winners.
That's right.
We are going to keep this going because people are like, oh, you need to spend more money to get more points. So the equivalent, the dollar equivalent of, for instance, going from nothing to bronze was the equivalent of, I think, 1,300. Off the top of my head, that might be wrong, whatever it is, but it worked out to something like that. And it was like, oh, it's so much harder to get to that level. Well, first of all, you're bumped up 5% without even doing anything.
Yeah.
So you can't be upset about that. Yeah, exactly. But for all the reasons, now people can understand that there is this system. But I kept saying, bang, where have you been, man? You just woke up. You missed it all. There are other ways to get points, and I'm so happy to now, you know, we started with the 4 points a day for logging in, and mad love to Alex Hughes for every day logging in, and boom, he's got 60 points right off the bat, just like that. Is we are going to finally be able... Lorenzo's watching the stream. Lorenzo, get back to work. You are finally going to be able to... Not finally able, we're very finally happy to be able to tell you guys and to enable you guys that you will be able to earn points by simply sharing your own personal link to your mates. And if they buy it under your link, you will get reward points for that. So this is another example of being able to earn points in a variety of different ways, not just by simply spending the money and getting the points that way, which of course you can do. But if you are sociable and giving it out to your mates and telling people and showing the love for us, which, you know, we always appreciate it when you guys do that, you can get actually rewarded for that as well. So really, really, really pumped to be able to tell you that you can now share it to your mates and get yourself some extra points. We will, over time, between now until then, most likely on the live stream of when we're going live, give a bit more detail on how many points that is and all that sort of good stuff.
We'll quickly explain how to share the link as well.
How to share the link, and all the technical stuff once people see what's going to happen.
It's totally new to a lot of people. Like, oh, I didn't know I could share a link and actually get points. Sure, we'll highlight the rules. We'll do another infographic on the website, which Sandy's working on, and obviously that should explain a little bit more of this sharing to a friend system.
Right.
It's another new system where you can actually earn more points.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sharing is not enough. They have to buy Alessio, to be clear. So one more time, guys, thanks very much for joining us. It has been, as always, love doing these streams with you guys. Jeff, did you enjoy that?
I sat through for the first time.
You know, you do some cameos every now and then, but you know, very nice to have you join us from the beginning to end. And thank you so much for revealing that and holding the Majora's mask. Can we give some love for Jeff, please, guys? Just to say thanks very much for joining us and joining us in the stream.
Thank you, guys.
And you know, obviously, we can explain that on the stream day.
You sure? Is that going to be enough time?
All right, over to you then.
Are you sure?
If you want, yeah, sure. All right, so there's your love for you, mate. Chocks is going to give you a bit more information. What did I say? Don't necessarily say that. Just explain the new system, yeah? Okay?
Are you sure?
Well, no. Well, just... Oh, okay.
I'll let you do it.
All right. We talked about points, and we're going to leave you... We don't want to over... You know, because we're gifting out these points so much, so often, so quickly, mm-hmm. there's so many new ways to earn them. I'm going to give you one more way, just let you know, just so you guys can prepare yourselves for the actual launch. There will be pre-order points to be earned extra should you place your order during the pre-order time. Now, what I mean by that is, let us say during the 2-week pre-order period, you place your order. Not only do you get your points that you get for purchasing it for $384.99 if you're getting the exclusive. Not only do you get those points, but you also get points for pre-ordering within the 2-week period. And that is the equivalent of the discount codes under the old system, which we can't do anymore. It's now a reward point system. We're giving you points on top of the points that you earn for buying it. You're going to get more points just for simply purchasing it during the 2-week period. But there's more. If you're a loyal guy, and you, well, I don't say loyal is the word. If you are, you know, if you're there at the moment that we go live for the first 12 hours, which is what we call over here the 0 hour, you will get a higher amount during those first 12 hours of reward points, in addition to the other ones that you would have got just by simply placing the order. You will be getting more points at the 0 hour window. And after that 0 hour window passes, 12 hours gone, those points that you earn for placing those orders reduce. So obviously it's a benefit for you guys ordering during 0 hour. But one more thing that allows for people to do mm-hmm. is not have to panic when they place their order about entering discount codes and coupon codes, all that sort of stuff. You don't need to worry about that. You just simply place an order, as long as it's within that 12-hour period, boom, 0 hour. As long as it's within that two weeks period, boom, reward points for simply purchasing it. Now, more than ever, you have no excuse if you're late with your pre-order the moment that we go live. F5. Oh, why you had to enter in my coupon code? No more. Straight away, you place the order, boom, it all automatically has it all.
Just to simplify that, basically, everyone gets points. Doesn't matter whenever you pre-order during those 2 weeks, everyone gets points. But if you pre-order it during the first 12 hours, which is the 0 hour, you get the hologram sticker, you get the extra card, plus extra points. So example, I don't know, maybe you get 300 points during 0 hour, and the remaining 2 weeks could be 100 points, right?
Yeah.
But what this means is that you don't have to send emails to CS anymore and say, hey, could you add my discount codes, blah, 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 blah. But so basically, whenever you pre-order during those 2 weeks, everyone gets extra points.
Got a question.
Really simple.
Is the points like already set? Or
we haven't set them yet.
We haven't set them yet.
We just sort of need to work out with a calculator. Yeah. How many points are we giving away? Don't bankrupt the company. You just got to make sure we're not doing that.
You get correct 2 points for 0 hour and 1 point for the rest of the week.
So hopefully,
will pending points for logging in be usable in this purchase? If they're pending, they're not yours. So the answer is no. Mm. So extra points for placements of coupons. That's correct, Jacob. We cannot longer do.
We move on to a new whole.
The whole new system. That's
whole
right.
Point system.
That's
so right. If we start mixing discount codes, it's gonna mess up the whole system.
That's right. So you get reward points if you place it. You get reward points when you buy it and it completes. You get reward points if you share it and your mates buy it as well.
You get rewards points for logging in, the giveaways, competitions. You know, like whatever. Like if we had some special event, you get points for that. Points for extra points for 0 hour, extra or just more points standard wise, like during the two-week pre-order as well.
Yeah.
So I don't know. What more can I say? That's a lot of points. You get points for doing.
So again, everybody was like, "Oh, it's so much more money to get to the next level." Yes, if you sit there and you just buy it. But we are trying to make it super easy for you guys to not only just buy to earn points. There's only so much I can actually do, other than actually just going to your mailbox and posting them in there myself.
Right, guys. After this stream, I'm going to make a post on the main page about this Majora mask.
Kevin, just to be clear, do not even think that 300 points is only $3. Please don't think 300 points is only $3. That is not the way you got to think about that. 300 points is 300 more points towards your next level. You have to consider how much money would you have had to have spent to earn those 300 points, as an example, right? That is what you got to consider. When you see the points, you don't just think of the monetary value. You got to think about your overall XP bar. How many more points you've got to get towards your next level. That is what you got to be focusing on. You've got to be focusing on the main prize, which is hitting that platinum number, getting to become a platinum member. And that is the point. You've got to think about the points as the build-up for your XP bar. And don't just spend them for your $3. It's not about that. It's about building it up to get to the next level.
That's right, guys. So after this stream, I'm going to make a post on the main page, and hopefully you guys can actually like enter that contest, share that out as well.
So what are you going to be posting on there?
And on there, there'll be 1,000 points
for
5 winners.
Another 1,000 points.
Another 5,000 points, you know, split across 5 individuals. And then I think I've actually posted a deadline on that as well. The winners will be chosen after the 2-week pre-order period ends.
Yeah. Ramon, if you're talking about expired points from your old system into the new one, no, you can't use that. That is your level, your stocks, your level in the XP bar. If you're talking about after you use them, under new points that you've got under the new system, after you've used them, it doesn't matter. It's already accounting to your overall level. Okay, I hope that explains it. So yeah. That is what. What about the photo Christmas contest, Alessio? It is absolutely being organized.
I'm
going
to
do it right now.
I'm ready to click that button after the stream ends. So make sure you cast your votes. I'm going to start bumping all those photos in there as well.
Yeah. Absolutely, guys. Once again, thank you so much for being here. 94 people, mad love, much appreciated. To my left, my boy Jeff. To my right, my main man Chocks. I'm your host, Alex. Thanks very much for joining, guys. As always, mad love. Thank you very much for joining us. We'll see you again, guys, on Tuesday for the launch of the Majora's Mask. Mad love. Thanks very much for joining. F4F is love. F4F is life. What on earth?
Have a good weekend, guys.
Is a Banjo-Kazooie.